Hey guys, this is Frank, and today we're going to talk about this charge-discharge board that I built to process all 2100 of my 18650 cells. And we're going to do that right now. Alright guys, this is the DIY Engineer channel. And on this channel, we do everything DIY, from concrete countertops to automotive to construction. Currently, we're working a bunch of 18650 power storage projects, including power walls and portable power generators. If you're interested in any of these topics, please subscribe below and be sure and hit the little bell so that you get notifications every time I post a new project or a new video around these projects. So with that, we're going to jump into this processing board for 18650 cells that I built to process pretty much all the cells behind me. Where I was thinking we would start with this is I have some previous video that I shot when I was actually building this board. It's kind of older, and I really want to apologize up front for the autofocus because the camera I was using was all over the place. Had a hard time focusing. But it'll give you a gist of some of the processes I used to at least build the lower section of this board. And then when we come back, I'll talk more about this upper section or what it took to build that and why I did things the way I did. So let's go watch those videos and then I'll come back and we'll discuss this top portion.
I have been working on this charging discharging table for a little while now. And actually I had an original that I had started here and I miscalculated the size of the switch holes and drilled them too big, so I had to redo it. Now I have this that I'm working on, and hopefully this melamine is going to work out really well. I kind of like this shelving material. And these brackets seem to mount really well, and they're stout. They're just really, really stout on there. So I'm hoping that this will help, and I'll do little tidbits of progress on this so that you can see how it all comes together. So all I'm doing now is just measuring out. You can see I measured out the edge here where this was the edge of the bracket itself or the holder. And then I put a line here and here to for the pins that drop down out the bottom of the holder. So each holder has pins that drop down, and those holes are set just perfectly so I can drop that right in there, and then I just line them up and then screw them down so that they're mounted nice and flush to the board. Very clean and neat and tidy. The lines go away. They are melamine just washes right off, so it'll clean up really nice. Once I am all done, I'll just take these off and wash all the lines off and it'll be good. But all right, go back to mounting some more brackets and then I'll get started on the charging units and their switches. All right, I thought I would share how I actually get this point. When I started, I mounted this center one here just perfect. There's a center line that goes right up through the middle, so I'm able to take the center line and bring it right to the center of the holder. So that way there I know that I'm at the center of the board. My board is 25 inches wide and 16 inches deep. So I have some room to work with it. And I'm hoping to get 28 chargers across the bottom, and then I got some discharge units. I should have 8 to 10 discharge units up on top. So this will be able to handle pretty much the load that I'm hoping to put on it. So how I got this to this point, how I figured this out, what I did is I figured out where these pins are. Way over here, if you look, the pins on the bottom are what our solder points is, where the soldering is going to go. And I needed to determine where those landed. And so what I did is I drew some lines that were very close to where those pins are. So these lines here represent where the pins need to go. And then to figure this out, all I did was mounted this, or just pushed this up against here. And then I drew little marks right where the pins are. Right now I'm just soldering up all of my TP4056 charging modules, and these will be connected on the backside. Hopefully I'll do a video here in the future where you can
see how I connect them underneath the melamine here. All of these have been drilled, marked and drilled specifically for these four socket charging banks. And then those will be bolted down to the board and put in place. And there'll be switches for each four pack so that I can turn them off as needed when charging my my 18650 cells. Right now I have hundreds of cells I need to charge, and I really need to get this done so that I can get them charged. I also have probably 200 cells that are ready for discharge. So I'm really needing this board right now. I just have a lot of cells to process.
Finally was able to get all of my charging units soldered, and I just stuck them through the holes so that they're not necessarily mounted down yet, but you can see how the wires go through and they're nice and discreet. And then these here will they'll mount, or I'll put wires on these little clips around the ends, and then those will attach to the wires underneath. And I have some of it together. I'm gonna see if I can lift this up and show you without making too big of a mess here. But you can see all the wires down there and how they come through. And then what I'm using is these little brackets here, focus there, to mount them together, to bring the wires together. And the reason I'm doing this is so it's modular. If I wanted to change out my holders, my 18650 battery holders here, I could put in different ones if I have a unit that goes out, because I'm an idiot and sometimes I've actually fried probably about six of these just because I put a battery in backwards. And one of the things I'm experimenting with right now is using a MOSFET to cause it so I don't, if I put the battery in backwards, it doesn't fry this unit or any of these units. But because I haven't gotten that mastered yet and worked out, I'm going ahead and just making these modular. They're so inexpensive, so it's not a big deal if I burn one up. But I just as soon not, if I can help it. But anyways, so that's what it kind of looks like so far. I've gotten several hours into this, but I'm quite pleased with it. I think it's gonna work out really well. My current setup that I have, that I'm using for charging right now, consists of about six units, and it's taking me a long time, and I have a couple discharge units that I'm using, but they're not ideal. So I'm hoping that this here will help solve my issues. One of the things that I did get in today, which I'm pretty excited about, are my resistors for discharging. I ordered these separately. See if I can get the focus here. Come on, focus camera. So these resistors, I ordered the aluminum ones because I want them to be able to breathe. I'm going to mount them on the back side, and there'll be a fan underneath that will help keep them cool.
Just wanted to give you an idea of some of the work that I've done here. So you saw how I put in these charging units. There's 28 of those, and they're each switchable. So I can actually shut those on and off based on each bank. So every four cells has the ability to shut off by using the main power switches, or these power switches here. Up here on the discharge section, this is used to determine how many milliamp hours are in each cell. So as I discharge them, I make sure that each cell, before I even put it in here, is charged to 4.2 volts. And I need to make sure that it's got the full voltage charge in it. So that way there, when I go to actually run the discharge, it will show the actual milliamp hours that I'm shooting for. And these four discharge units are tied to these four cells, these four to these four cell holders, and these four dischargers here are to these this cell set. So that is the basic flow of it. Now what I'll do is I'm going to turn the board over and let's take a look at the underside. And you really can't laugh because it is a rat's nest under there. But let's go ahead and take a look at that. All right, so this is the underneath the board. You have to remember that this was kind of an experiment to see how things would work out. And so I've tried a couple different things. You notice in my original videos, the old videos, I actually had little bus bars in between the charging units, these guys here, which you can't see, and the actual cell bricks across those 28 charging units across the bottom. And those were working out okay, and I finally went back and just put in these bus bars and then just soldered everything to bus bars. So it simplified it by using, this is just 14 gauge, just regular electrical wire stripped out of just house wire, and just stretched it in there. It works out really well to provide the voltage that I need. These ports here, I used an old power supply. I stripped down an old AT power supply. It was like a 500 watt power supply, and rerouted the 5 volt into here. So these two here are 5 volt, and this up here is actually a 12 volt to provide power for the discharge units. And I had to do some step downs just to make sure that I kept the voltages consistent. And that's what these units are here. I'm going to have a complete parts list in the description below, so you can look to that parts list to see, you know, where I got everything and kind of get ideas on costs. I got a little bit of money into this, but it's not too terrible. I think that in the long run, it all worked out because I was able to process so many cells with this table. And it's a mess. So these over here are the MOSFETs I was testing out to see if I could get it to save the cells. The problem I ran into with using the MOSFETs, it did work. It kept me from burning out more of the charging units, the little charging units, when I put a cell in backwards because I'm an idiot sometimes. But the cost of these MOSFETs was almost, you know, the price of having to replace all of the charging units. And so to me, it was like, just be a little smarter and do it right. So I left these in here. It was a good experiment. One of the things I did find with these MOSFET gates is they had a tendency, I think, to slow the charging rate down a little bit. I don't know why it would do that, because it's really just a gate. And the cells didn't always charge up as high as I'd want them to. I mean, they would get up around, 4.15, 4.12. They wouldn't get as high as I'd like as they did with the units where I didn't have the MOSFET. So I don't know that I would recommend it. It's something that if you wanted to play with, you could. I did here and just found that it really came down to it wasn't worth it to me. These little buck converters allow me to take and drop voltages down. So to go into these units here, I think they want a 5 volt continuous. And so when I was feeding power into those, I needed to make sure that I dropped them down to the right voltage so that I wasn't burning out those units, those charging units. And the same for the discharge units on the other side. I had to take and control the voltages there as well. So there are step-down units for each of those discharge units. Then you'll notice what I did is I wired in my resistors for the discharge on the back side here. That way there, they weren't up and exposed. This worked out really well, especially when I put these larger fans. You see, I have these larger fans up on top that would blow on them. So anytime I turned on the power switch for specifically this bank of discharge and this bank of discharge, these fans came on and cooled down the resistors so that they stayed cool almost all the time. It really worked out well to have those fans on there. And it didn't affect the discharge in any way that I could tell. I was still able to get good milliamp hour readings out of the discharge units. So that's kind of the back end of my board. It is a rat's nest, and I apologize for that. I will leave information in the description below where you can find all of these parts. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe below, and also come visit my website at thediengineer.com and learn more about some of the projects that I'm doing. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate your support. Just as an update, things have actually really taken off with my DIY channel. I am finding that within the last 90 days, I've actually got 400 subscribers, and my views have really gone up higher than I thought they ever would. This is something I just never dreamed of happening. It's
I just wanted to share, but it looks like there really is an interest in 18650 processing. So I appreciate the support, and tell your friends, subscribe, click the bell so you get updates, and we'll catch you on the next video. Thanks for watching.